Hello, welcome back. I'm Claire, this is Purple Puppy, and today I am working on my little book of collage, and this next sheet has got four rectangles on it. So we're folded in half, so we've got our full page. We can get rid of that for a moment. Now, I've got this page of photographs from Witchcraft Do You Do. You know, I've got a lot of kits from them. And they are basically the same size as these frames. So I thought that maybe today was the day to have some fun and games with some photographs. So I've got some stamped calico. I've got some Tim Holtz decoupage paper, whatever. And here I have a variety of leaves and plants that I've dried. So there's our background page for our little journal book. Let's start by getting these four pictures. Now, as you'll see, four of them are portrait and four are landscape. Well, we've got portrait squares, so they're the four we need. We'll set the other four to one side. Now I'm just going to turn them out and check exactly the sizing. And this is just printed on 70 gram copier paper, so it's very, very thin. But when you're going to be sticking it down as we are, it doesn't matter at all. Now, they are slightly bigger, but I don't think it's going to matter. So I'm going to go for the time being with the size that they're at. We could always trim off the white frame. I'm just wondering if we've got two together, does that then become a problem? Because if I go there to there, so if I line it up with the top and I line it up with the bottom, we still get that space. Now they're going to be fine. So I'm going to stick with that. And we're going to do some change up. We're going to have a bit of fun playing with these, making them a bit unique. I talk quite a lot about making digital kits your own. Obviously, you have to be careful. You can't print them any differently because that's a copyright issue. But you can definitely, add things to them, like I'm going to maybe even colour them in. So black and white like this. It's entirely up to you. Now, I'm looking at this and it's almost like we've got a family here, because we've got a lady and a man. So we've got a mum and a dad. Well, dad was always head of the household, so he better go first. And then we've got mum. And then we've got the three children. So it's like a family, okay. So, on these printed or stamped calico pieces, I've got lots of signatures and things. But this one here says publishers and booksellers. It's too big. But it will go on the side there. So we might, that's how he makes his money maybe. So that could be that one. And then I'm thinking, we take some decoupage paper. If you haven't got this, you could use a napkin. Now you can't see much, but I know that once you add glue to this, it goes transparent. And I think it's more appropriate really for the boy, isn't it, because it's got a bug and that on it. So I'm going to tear a piece of that off for the boy. He had that big bag on him. And then in my dry pile here, I've got this beautiful pressed flower. And I'm thinking we could put that there almost like a fan, or maybe coming off the corner like that. So that could be her. And then for the children, we need a smaller flower. My leaves are all sliding out. We need a smaller flower, or we need some leaves or something. Let's have a little look. What have we got here? Whoops. I've got this smaller flower, but we used this one last time, so I don't want to use that again. We have got this red one. I wonder, it's quite big though. Ah, now this one has got a certain amount of red in it, and it's smaller, so we could maybe use that. Or I'm worried, is it a bit too similar because we've got a flower in the other one? Should I be looking maybe at lace or something for those children, the two girls? So if I look in my little book, in my box here, I've got various bits. So maybe we could find some lace for her scarf. That's a bit big. We need something small. Don't know. Let's get on and play with these to start with. That'll be much more fun, won't it? And then we'll see how we get on. So I'm going to move all this to one side, and I'm going to bring in the man first of all. And I need to trim this, so I'm wondering if I trim this side and pull that down like that, we've got publishers and bookkeepers there. That can come on the edge. And then we could look at trimming it once it's glued down. Whoops. So let's get my messy mat up. Get a tube that's got some glue in it. We'll run all the way down there. Just wanna line that stamping up again, because where I've torn it, it's gone a bit southward. Make sure that it's all on the photo. Roll that down on that bit of tape. Whoops. And then if I trim this off, then it's almost like an advert for his business. Yeah? So that could be that one. So that's my first one. We've got to do it on that bottom corner, haven't we? There we go. That's him. Just lifts that photograph a little bit, that's all. And then this one for the little boy, I need some PVA. And my palette. I'm just going to put a little bit of PVA in there and some water to dilute it a bit, and then take my brush. Mix in that water. No, that's the glue, that's the water. Okay. And then if we cover that completely, we don't want to go too much because this is only an inkjet print and we don't want all the colours to run. Then we go over the top. You can see the little boy in the background under the bugs, which I like. Now, I'm going to have to leave this, I think, to dry before we stick it down. Let's see, can we do it? Oh, maybe. I'll do it carefully. Okay, so that's that. Whoops, yep. I now need to turn my mat round because I don't want to get glue all over my book page here. So, oh, which one I glue in? That one. Might as well do it with the glue as we've got it out. And then this one needs to go on the, whoa, careful Claire. There. So then, can see the little boy behind. I love it. And then we have got Mum. Now she's got this frill on her dress. I'm wondering whether to line it up like that. Yes, I think that's where I'm going. So I've broken off that bit. Actually, let's use the PVA, it's here, isn't it? So, I'm going to coat the back like that. Set that there to go a bit sticky. We'll glue up this one. And then we've got to sort out the lace for the little girls, haven't we? So this is Mum and she's going centre bottom like that. Okay. And then we'll bring this in and we are going to stick it right across there like that. That's her. They just look completely different, don't they? I need to rub off that glue where I dropped it. Okay, they look completely different. I love them. Now, where are my little girls? Here are my little girls. Now, she's got a fluffy hat and a fluffy scarf. Ooh. Now, this bit here might work as her scarf. So, put a little bit of glue there where her scarf is. And put it round there like that. Obviously that purple will go. It comes round her head like that. We can then maybe use this bit as a hat. We can. So I think I have to cut off that bit and that bit. And then that's her hat. Look. Such fun. And that's her hat and scarf. As I say, that purple will go, so that's fine. I'm gluing the page rather than the picture because of the bump. Oh, see, I didn't want to stick it on that glue, did I? And then I'll put her, or them, because there's two girls. And we're just going to add a little bit of glue on that end. And this one needs a little bit extra there as well. So, we haven't got any under this stalk. There we go. So, there you go. Fun with photos. You just see his face poking through there, through the wings. I love it. I just think it makes a real change to the photos that we had. If you're going to go away and have a go at this, think of all the things you could use to put on top of a photo to make it your own. As always, thank you so much for being with me. I hope you found some joy and inspiration. Stay safe. I'll see you very soon. Ta-ta for now.